We're in this together.
We're in this together. We're in this together.
Morning, it's April 9th. I'm Captain Joseph O'Brien. I'm the mission commander for Task Force New York City, embarked aboard USNS Comfort. Recently, we switched from taking COVID negative patients to taking patients regardless of their COVID status, and we've seen an increase in bed usage because of that. We're working closely with our Army brothers and sisters over to Javits Center to make sure that we are balancing the full capabilities of the DoD to support the efforts here in New York City. Comfort is focusing on taking high acuity patients while we work with our partners over at the Javits Center to support lower acuity patients. We have currently treated approximately 80 personnel, including over 40 people in the intensive care unit. All patients are receiving high quality care. The Comfort team remains focused on our mission, which is to relieve pressure on New York City hospitals, and we're doing a great job with that. Tuesday evening, into early Wednesday morning, the Comfort Javits team expedited the transfer of 10 critical patients from a local hospital. All were ICU patients requiring a high level of care that they're currently receiving on board Comfort. If I can give a message to the Comfort team, it's that you are making a difference. The patients that we are seeing are relieving the pressure on the New York City hospital system, and they're receiving high quality care from each and every one of you, and I appreciate everything you're doing for them. Thank you very much.
Good morning, I'm Captain Amersbach. I'm the commanding officer of the Military Treatment Facility, and today is April 9th. We continue to take non-COVID as well as COVID patients now, and we've treated almost 80 to this point. Our ICUs are very busy with both of those patient populations as well as that of the ward. We've conducted multiple surgeries, and we are also providing dialysis services for some of our patients on board. We continue to do what we can to safeguard that of our crew as well as our patients. We have environmental controls in place as well as following as strictly as we possibly can CDC guidelines for social distancing and the use of PPE. We've moved approximately half of our staff off of the ship to decompress the berthing areas as well as the galley, further allowing that social distancing to occur. We are here in New York City to provide high quality care to the people in New York City, and that is our ultimate goal, as well as that of protecting the crew aboard the ship. We are very happy to be here and will continue our mission to the best of our abilities in support of the city of New York. Thank you very much for your time. We really appreciate it. Thank you.
Lieutenant J.G. Stephanie Benn, serving on the USNS Comfort. My job while I'm here is I'm a Navy Reserve nurse, and currently I'm working in this hospital tent behind me. When patients come in on the ambulance, we determine whether they have been tested for COVID-19. If they have no COVID test on record, then they come in this tent, we test them for COVID-19, and that determines where we place them for care on the ship. It takes about 45 minutes, and they're hoping to get something to shorten that time frame. But by the time we do the test, time it, it's ran to the lab up on the ship, up on the 01 deck, which is a ways up. And then for that to process with all the other labs and come back to us, it's about an hour and a half. So we get some good time down here with them to kind of explain what's going on and make them more comfortable with the process. One of our patients that came in was not really sure where she was at. She was scared. She had a bad appendix, and she was getting some IV treatment for that at a hospital, but was moved to us for continuing care. She was an unknown COVID-19, so we placed her in our tent. We explained the process and explained to her that we were going to continue to take care of her, but we needed to know her COVID-19 status to know and determine where to place her on the ship. She was unaware that the ship was here in New York City, and she was very scared about being positive and what was going to happen to her. So I sat down with her and explained everything, and we found out she was negative, so we placed her on the ward that was a negative COVID-19 ward for her to continue to get her IV antibiotics so then she could hopefully go home soon. And she was thrilled to find out she was negative and was pretty tearful, which, you know, is emotional for us too because we know they're scared. So explaining it to her, she was very appreciative, and she's getting her care continued. One of our patients that came in had been hit by a motorcycle, had fractured his wrist, wondered what we were all doing in Army fatigues. And when I explained to him that we were Navy nurses and corpsmen taking care of patients from the overflow of the hospitals, he was very appreciative. He said that he didn't realize that this was where he was going and that he could possibly even have surgery on the ship. So they were able to fix his wrist and cast it. And yesterday we saw him come to the discharge tent, and we were able to go and wish him well. And he was very appreciative and said that he has a great story to tell from here on out about his time here. Yes, I did volunteer. I feel quite honored and humbled to be here and to be able to do my part to help combat this virus, because I feel as a nurse that this is our frontline experience with the war on this virus, and the support from the community, how we were received here in New York City, coming into the harbor, and just from the patients who are just so thankful to have care. I'm just hoping that our time here is well spent and that we can make a difference.
Hi, I'm Hospital Corpsman First Class Brittany Berkeley from Hampton, Virginia. I'm stationed here currently on the USNS Comfort. I am a member of the ground team here with patient transport. Our job is to make sure that patients are getting where they need to be with the correct care at the correct time. So we have to manage three different types of communication from our radio and three different chat groups or information systems. So we have a system where we have people out in town who are generating information from the patients and finding patients that will match our needs or what we have here at the Comfort. And from there, that information gets translated to the MOC, and the MOC is the medical officer in charge. And once that information gets to him, it gets disseminated out to the various departments so that we know where they're going, what their needs are, and who's coming and when they're going to be here, which allows us to provide that proper transportation for our patients. So how it works is the MOC communicates with different parties, and because we're also part of that communication, we also get the information. So when there's a vehicle here to come in, we're notified that that vehicle is here. We call the transport team so that they're here when the vehicle arrives, and then we have the information on who the patient is so that if they need extra care, like if they're going to the ICU and they need some ventilation, we have that information as well. It's been a lot of interesting pieces and kind of building this from the ground up. It started from three chairs and three people in the colds. Now we have two tents currently and three teams working effectively. So it's been a great experience seeing these people come and being super grateful and super amazed at kind of what they're actually being a part of. And here it is, one of those once in a lifetime opportunities that we get to be a part of because this has never happened before. So when patients are arriving to us, some are super excited to be here and to be a part of the process. And some are a little apprehensive just because we are intimidating. Coming up on a group of people in yellow gowns, gloves, and masks, and seeing white tents can be extremely scary. So myself and my nursing staff here, we try to make them as comfortable as possible. Giving them great eye contact, talking to them, smiling with them, communicating with them, making sure that they have everything that they need from also the EMS staff as well as we. So that kind of alleviates a lot of the apprehension as well as the nervousness, It is a scary time for a lot of the older population, so we try to make them at ease as much as possible. You smile with your eyes. You're smiling in your mask, but when you smile, your eyes also smile. So giving them that eye contact and letting them know that they're gonna be okay. When patients come down, they're super grateful. I actually talked to one of the members that was getting discharged the other day, and he was super happy to not only be going home, but to be able to receive the care that he did. There was also another gentleman that was being discharged, and he was the most sweetest older man. He was so happy. He almost tried to pay some people, but we were like, no, sir, we're here for you. So we're just happy that you're healthy and you're able to go home. So everybody seems to be really, really happy with the care they're receiving on board, with the hospitality and the bedside manner. So I've heard nothing but great things. So I'm hoping that the momentum keeps going. We keep getting patients in and also getting them out, because that's our goal to hear. So when we receive patients that are getting discharged, a lot of the feedback is genuine happiness. They are excited about the care that they received, the hospitality that they received between the nursing staff as well as our corpsman staff. They rave about the people that are on the wards. Some of them don't want to go, so we can't keep them as much as we want to. We can't, but they love it here. They definitely appreciate the time and the effort that we've all taken to participate and alleviate some of the madness that's currently going on. I am a nurturer by nature, so being able to put that into practice and help people and save lives and change their lives, it's an awesome opportunity for us. I'm a hospital corpsman by trade, nurturer by nature, so it kind of plays into that. And just being able to see people leave healthy and happy. So as long as I can do that and we can be a part of that, couldn't ask for anything else.
How's it going? I'm hospital corpsman second class Brandon Day from Naval Medical Center Portsmouth. I've been in the Navy about 6 years now, originally from Camas, Washington. And I'm here now augmented on the USNS Comfort. So I'm a surgical technologist here on the ship. We are here to do just about any kind of surgery you could imagine. My primary responsibility here is equipment and supply. So meaning I keep the equipment in the operating rooms running, testing them, coordinating with our biomedical department on board to make sure that these things don't break in the middle of surgery. So during, before, during, and after procedure, so we set up and maintain a sterile field, meaning we try to create a microbe and bacteria-free environment. So we do so using, you know, sterile tools, sterile instruments, clean gear, skin preparations, and things of that nature. We also are the patient advocate during surgery, maintaining sterility. If there's ever a break, we're the ones who call people out and make sure that we get it fixed, get it corrected, and that the patient stays safe. I'm excited to be here in New York. It's not too often that we get to deploy to our own country to help out our own people. It's very rare, actually. And I'm just happy to be here. I'm glad that we get to help take care of these patients. It's nice to have a job that can actually make a difference, something that you can see physically, visibly. It's wonderful. It's great.
Hey, everyone. Good afternoon. It's me again, Patricia Gregadello. As you guys can see, we actually have a new change of scenery. A lot of us got moved down to the pier. So we're on day 14. It's April 9th today. It's been about a week since the last time I got to talk to everybody, so I just wanted to give a little bit of an update on what's been going on over here. So we've been trying to make sure that all the patients' labs are done and just making sure we know exactly where they're going and what's going on with them. So we're doing that all at the pier now. You guys can kind of see a little bit of what we got going on. Lots of tents and things like that. It's cool. Just a little bit of a personal update. I did find out my husband's actually mobilizing also. He's a corpsman as well. And I have two kids at home, so that's been really scary for me, just knowing that my kids aren't going to have their parents home. God bless my mother-in-law, who's going to be taking care of them. So it's just been, it's been a little bit of a rough one. I do want to say thank you to everybody. Receiving the outreach that I did after my first video has been so just motivating, and it is so awesome finding out how much you guys all care about us. Thank you for keeping up with us.
Hello, everybody. I'm Lieutenant Crossman. I am the OR con here on board USNS Comfort, and I'm going to take you on a tour through our operating room suites, pre-op. We're going to take a little sneak peek at that. Come on, let's go. All right, so this here is our front desk area of the OR. Everybody wave, say hi. So we have an outstanding crew here in the operating room. We work together quite often back at Naval Medical Center Portsmouth. Some of us are from other commands. Some of us have met before on previous deployments. But right here, as we're standing in our pre-op area, you notice we have six bays. This is where our patients arrive from the wards and from casualty receiving or ICU, wherever the need may be. And they come here to get teed up for surgery. They'll meet with their surgeon, their anesthesia provider, their operating room nurse, and get all their questions answered, get everything all ready, consents all signed, make sure they have what we call informed consent, which is where we perform nothing on a patient that they don't understand what's happening to them. All right, everybody, so we're gonna go into one of our 12 operating suites here on board Comfort, but before we actually enter the room, I wanna point out this little yellow line right here. This is our scrub line. This is where to go past this point, you have to don proper surgical attire, scrub cap, scrubs, OR shoes or shoe covers. So we're gonna go into operating room number 11. This is one of our 12. So here in this room, as you can see, it's very easily accessible from our pre-op holding area. So this room is typically reserved for our emergency trauma cases. So if we need additional resources from throughout the ship, they can be mobilized in a quick fashion without having to drag foot traffic through to all of the rest of our operating suites. So here in this room, you can see very large, very spacious. We have backup oxygen available right here in all of our operating suites. You can see our OR table right here. So a couple things that make these operating rooms a little different than other operating rooms. You'll notice our OR lights have fancy brackets to keep them swinging when we're at sea. So right over here, you can see we have our anesthesia cart and our anesthesia machine here behind me, all nice and ready to go to receive the patient. So now we're gonna walk down into our sterile core. Our operating suites have a racetrack designed with a sterile core running right through the middle. All right, so this is our sterile core. Goes all the way down. We got six ORs on one side, six on the other side. And here, right behind me, they're wrapping up from treating a patient, so we're gonna stay out of their way right here. This is operating room number six. Say hey, guys.
How's it going?
This is our interventional radiology suite right here. It's a hybrid operating room, so we can shoot radiological images while maintaining a sterile environment and treating the patient. So we're gonna continue walking down our sterile core. We're very fortunate to have a nice, clean elevator here that goes to our sterile processing department. And then right here we have malignant hyperthermia cart, and on the other side of me we have our difficult airway cart, all nice and prepared. So we're going to continue walking down again. We got 12 operating suites. We're very fortunate to be able to have this sterile core. We have all of our supplies right here in the middle, so they're accessible from every operating room. All right, now we are coming to the back of that racetrack design, which is at the end of our sterile core. So very important for operating rooms is to maintain a contained air environment. So we have all of the doors that lead to the operating rooms are able to be secured while the ship is at sea, as you can see right here. And back here we have our pathway to the post-anesthesia care units. This is the direction that the patients will come as they leave their operating room ready to be recovered by a PACU staff. All right, so this is our post-anesthesia care unit. We have a 20-bay PACU here on board Comfort. And each of these bays are all hooked up for wireless telemetry, and they are also double-dipped as a critical care bed if needed. So we're gonna come around to our nurse's station. So we keep the PACU man, and while we're doing patient care, we keep an anesthesia provider always available in PACU. So everybody say hi. So here's where we can monitor our patients on their telemetry, and directly behind me, you will find a door going straight to the intensive care unit for patients that need that expeditious transfer. And that is our post-anesthesia care unit. So now we're walking back towards the OR suite, back towards our sterile core. We're gonna hook the left, and we're gonna take a look at our supply department. So our supply department works really hard to maintain the supplies throughout the ship, because we don't only supply the operating room, but a lot of our supplies are utilized throughout the ship. So what's going on, guys?
Hi, sir.
So we're still putting some supplies away, getting all nice and organized. We got all these nice functioning racks that maneuver to allow us to have some more room. All right, so leaving our supply department, we're gonna head back up towards the front. That concludes our tour of the operating suites here on the USNS Comfort. This is my third mission on board the Comfort, the third in 2 years. Very happy to be here. These missions are always very exciting. Myself and the rest of the crew have dedicated our adult lives to providing medical care to people of all national origins and in all situations, and the United States Navy gives us a platform to do it like no other organization on earth. So this is my second mission in a row as the OR Con here of our operating room. It goes by a couple of names over on the civilian side: OR Con, board runner, head nurse, charge nurse. You get the idea. I'm responsible for all of the patient flow and the patient care that happens here within the operating suites and coordinating with the outside departments, talking with anesthesia and surgeons, making sure we're all on the same page, doing the same mission at all times. Last year on our last mission, I myself actually had surgery in these operating suites. I had all four of my wisdom teeth extracted. It was great, loved it. The quality of care that we provide here is second to none. I would put myself or my family on these operating tables in a moment's notice, without a doubt. A lot of the crew here, we've worked together in previous deployments. We worked together over at Naval Medical Center Portsmouth and other commands, and it's a very tight-knit crew, and it's an absolute joy to work here in New York City. So here we are, back where we started, in front of the operating suites. If you find yourself on board and come to the operating room, we'll be here to take care of you. All right, goodbye.
Lieutenant Commander Chad Hamilton, Command Chaplain. So my role in support of the crew and the patients on this mission is really to be a source of support and encouragement. We visit the patients and also provide morale support for the staff, for the crew. Sometimes they're stressed out and they may want to come talk to a chaplain, because with the chaplain it's all confidential what they share. So we're a great resource for the morale of the crew. Easter Sunday is a sacred day in the Christian world. So we're providing general Christian worship services on the flight deck, so it lessens exposure, and also at the hotel where the hospital staff are staying, in the ballroom there. And then in addition to that, we pre-recorded a Catholic Mass that we're providing that for our Catholic folks as well. And then in the afternoon, we're also doing a service for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. There are a lot of people that are religious and people who aren't. But even people who aren't, when we talk about spirituality, we're talking about what gives purpose to their life. And as a chaplain, we can help sort of clarify that. And sometimes when we're talking about just general stress, it has a lot to do with feeling out of control. And so, you know, we talk about, you know, there are so many things that we can't control, but what can we control? And certainly we can decide what we want to think about and what gives us meaning and talk about things about self-care. I often refer to the Serenity Prayer. It says, God, give me the courage to change the things that I can, the serenity to accept the things that I can't, and the wisdom to know the difference. That's sort of a great motto, a great prayer, a great philosophy. The last couple of weeks, you know, with the mission has evolved, as we know. We're now taking COVID-19 patients. And so there's some staff that are stressed by that. But what has inspired me is that I've talked to more than a few who aren't stressed out or worried about getting the COVID-19. I mean, maybe some of it is being, you know, sort of, they're younger and invincible, but they're talking about being focused on the mission and doing their job. You know, as a Navy, we not only protect the nation, but in this case, we're able to help the citizens of New York City. You know, difficult times have come throughout the history of the world. Certainly this is something that is not something that we've faced since 1918 with that flu pandemic, but it'll pass. And having a hope for something better, having a hope for the future, having hope is important, I think, for all of us. And things will get better. They always do.